This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree.
In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to take a look at a relatively common Indiana shrub, oftentimes found arching over small streams or on moist hillsides, and that is witch hazel. Witch hazel has an interesting history. Historically, and I think maybe even still today, it sometimes has some medicinal uses. Witch hazel has these very interesting leaves that are almost as broad as long, relatively short leaf stems. The leaves are held alternately on the twigs, and you'll notice a relatively wavy margin on the outside edge of the leaves. And sometimes a pointed tip, sometimes much more of a rounded tip on the end of those leaves. So alternate simple leaves with wavy margins and quite broad, sometimes nearly as wide as long. One of the other interesting characteristics of witch hazel are the buds, tanned to brown and held on a little stalk. So you see them sticking up away from the actual leaf stems. Witch hazel has another very interesting and unusual characteristic, and that is it actually flowers in the fall. And so witch hazel produces little yellow spidery looking flowers, yellow flowers with very thin yellow petals, in November. And so it's one of our latest flowering species, and really is actually quite surprising when we run into it in the winter flowering out where everything else is dormant. Those flowers ultimately turn into a capsule which contains 2 or 3 seeds. Witch hazel has a very open form, multi-stemmed, gray bark on the twigs, relatively smooth, and as I mentioned, oftentimes kind of arching over small stream beds on the banks. So witch hazel, one of our very interesting native Indiana shrubs.